Welcome back to another one, guys. This is the first video back since New York City. I figure I'd just do a quick little unboxing since I haven't done one in quite a long time now. This is the PolarPro Peter McKinnon Variable NDs, 82mm, and then I have a step-up ring for the 85, and got the 2-5 stop and the 6-9 stop. Full disclosure, I've already opened these, I've already used these on the whole New York City trip, and just kind of going over a little bit of stuff with them. If you watched my New York City vlog, episode 1, you'll see that I had opened this, right? And part of the packaging of the case was broken. I'll show you really quick again. The boxes, the packaging on these is just super, super, super nice. So let's get it open here. First thing, obviously, when you open it up, you have one of Pete's pictures there. Then you got the hard case with the filter in it. Then down below, you have the soft pouch, and on this pouch, it actually has a built-in microfiber, which is really cool, because half the time you have to stuff another one in there, and then you just are smudging up the glass even more, trying to clean it, basically. So it comes with that. Then you have this little pamphlet here, probably warranty info and all that kind of stuff. And then these ones actually have a microfiber, but it's another one of Peter's pictures on the microfiber. And that kind of wraps up for the packaging again. Packaging is pretty simple, but it is a very nice touch, and it just shows that they went the extra distance on these to actually make them all, you know, as nice as possible. The presentation's really, really good. And the 82s, the 2-5 and the 6-9 stop, the packaging is the exact same. So I'll open one of these, and it's got this magnetic case. First thing that I'll say is I did have an issue with the case. I actually had to super glue all these magnets back in, only on the 2-5. The 6-9 I haven't had an issue yet, just on this one. Not a big deal, because it just looks like from the factory there was like hot glued in, and you know, it's magnetic. So the glue has to be able to withstand the magnetic pull of the two magnets, which I just pulled out. Not a big deal, super glued them back in there, it's fine. So when you open it up, you have this right here, which is, this is going to be the filter itself. It actually has the PolarPro rugged lens cap cover on it in the box, which is also really nice. And here is the filter itself. This is the 2-5 stop. And it actually stops when you go to each end, so most variable NDs, if you ever use one, you can just keep spinning it and spinning it and spinning it. And these actually have indicators for, not sure if this is going to focus or not, but it actually has little stops. So you actually know how many stops and how much light you're taking out by using that. And with these, since it's 2-5 and 6-9, that's going to stop you from getting the X and the weird distortion in your footage when you're actually using variable NDs. Because, like, I have a Tiffin, it's somewhere, I think it's in the closet. But the Tiffin one, it worked great. It's just when you really start getting it darker, when you're in really bright sun, I notice that you start getting the X that goes across the screen, and then it just makes the footage unusable. Another thing I did notice with this, on the edges of the filter, you can see like little imperfections. It's like whatever material is in between the rings, it's almost like a felt or something in there is loose. So I actually have to take pictures of this and email them, and I'll keep you guys updated with that whole thing to see how the PolarPro customer services. I'm assuming it's great, just because how extra and how basically how far they go with even the packaging to make sure everything is, you know, top notch. So I'm assuming I won't have any issue getting a replacement or anything like that. It could be something I can do just here. They may tell me just to take it apart and actually remove something in there, because that's what it looks like a piece of coating or just something is in there. But the whole point of the ND is to be able to cut down light so you can see through it, and it gets lighter and then it gets darker as you turn it, so you can cut down light. And the whole purpose of doing that, say you want to do long exposures in the daytime, you want to shoot wide open at 2.8, you know, 1.4, 1.2, whatever you want to shoot wide open at, you're going to need this to cut down that light. Otherwise, you have to adjust your shutter speed, and then you don't get smooth motion blur, and you get that kind of, like, stop motion look, which, if that's what you're going for, that's great, but if it's not, then it's obviously not going to be the look you're going for. But overall, I use these for the past week, every single day, and I have not had any issues. I didn't have any of the weird X's going across the footage or anything like that, or weird distortions from the filter, so everything was good there. I will do kind of like a secondary review, or just kind of touch base with you guys about what PolarPro says, what I need to do to have it fixed or replaced, and go from there. And again, the packaging is all going to be the exact same. I will open up the 6-9 stop one just to give you guys a quick look at it as well. Let me know down below what filters you use, what brand filters, what kinds of filters, if you use, you know, like just a full stop ND where you use a different ND for each stop, or if you use a variable ND. What do you guys think about UV filters? I kind of touched base on that stuff in my last vlog too, but just trying to get some more opinions on what you guys use and try to figure out, you know, it's always good to see what tools other people are using. So this is the 6-9 stop here. Same thing, you got the packaging here, you got the hard case. Again, this one I did not have the same trouble with the magnets. These ones were all still glued in there and fine. That one, not really sure what happened with it, but you know, nothing's perfect, especially in manufacturing. So again, this is a 6-9 stop. And again, it comes with the rugged lens cover, the hard case. And again, in the bottom of the box, it's going to have the same pouch, the paperwork, and a microfiber. Well, that about wraps it up for this one, guys. Give it a like if you liked it. Get out there, make it happen. Get subscribed if you're not already. And leave a comment down below about the filters and everything like that. If you have any questions about any of these things or anything you kind of want to see with them, anything more in depth or anything like that, just leave it down below and I'll try and get back with you guys and keep creating more videos like this and more reviews and just trying to push out as much content as possible. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. These glasses just are always smudged, like permanently smudged, and then it's like I use a microfiber and they're just even more smudged than before. Like, good enough.